Being quick in F1 24 is one thing, but being able to pass the driver in front of you is a whole other game. So if you're struggling to make progress in a race, this video is for you. Today we'll discuss 4 techniques you can use to overtake other drivers. So let's not waste any time and jump right in. Once you catch another driver, it's important to concentrate on how they drive. For example, are they early on the brakes into slow corners? Are they taking early or late apexes? Maybe they struggle with one specific corner on the track. From this, you can begin to plot your attack. The first overtake we'll look at is the simple cutback. This is where you brake on the outside, forcing the driver to defend their position on the inside, meaning they have a compromised, more shallow line through the corner. This means you can take a wide entry to prioritise your exit in order to get good traction out of the corner and pass the other driver. Of course, this won't work everywhere, so it's better to choose a low speed corner followed by a straight so you can maximise the effectiveness of this manoeuvre. By studying how your opponent is driving, you can start to plan where this might be possible. For example, I was racing at the Red Bull Ring, and the obvious place where this move could work is turn 3 due to the sharp apex sandwiched between two long straights. So I made sure to get a good run through turn 1 and use a slipstream to stay close up to turn 3. The driver in front, as expected, goes to the inside to defend, but makes the mistake of attempting a half-hearted move on the car in front. I was able to take the wide line and then cut underneath. Due to the elevation, I did have a kick of oversteer, but thankfully, with the traffic holding the other driver up, I was able to get alongside and make the pass. Now let's take things up a notch. The DRS train is where you have a line of cars unable to get close to each other on the straights, as everyone has DRS and slipstream, meaning any advantage is nullified. Additionally, they can't close up in the corners either due to the dirty air from the car in front. The fabled DRS train prevents you from getting close enough to the car in front of you to make any kind of impact, so in this circumstance, you have to think outside of the box. This usually means analysing the driver in front lap after lap to find a small chink in the defensive armour, or just attempt a doomed dive bomb. We've already mentioned about looking at how a driver takes each corner so you can find a vulnerability, and that is particularly the case here, but there is also a hint of opportunism when you see an opening. You see, what may work when it's a one-on-one may be slightly less effective in a group of cars. In Montreal, I was stuck in a DRS train, and I noticed that I was significantly quicker through turn 1 than the cars in front, but it normally meant just getting held up. However, I also noticed they stick to one line, so I try the outside line, and because of the additional momentum I'd built up through turn 1, I could drive right round the outside of turn 2 and complete the move. But you may think it would be difficult to learn how you can put yourself in these situations. Well, it's not as tricky as you may think, and how I knew to go faster through turn 1 is by analysing my data on Track Titan. Track Titan can not only show your session insights right down to your throttle and brake traces, but can also provide personalised tips based on your individual performance. Additionally, as you start to get more accustomed to the platform, you could toggle on Advanced Mode, which allows you to view the data the way professional drivers would do in real life. By signing up a Track Titan with the code OVERTAKE, you can get 30 days of unlimited data insights for free to help you get quicker, faster. Now let's discuss giving your opponent false ideas. You could of course force them into a mistake, but you can also sell them a dummy move, i.e. going to the outside on corner approach, and then just before braking switching back across to take the inside line. This will only work under certain circumstances, and here, on the approach to turn 11 at Bahrain, the long preceding straight and the sharp braking zone offers a great opportunity to perform the dummy, and I found myself in the perfect scenario. So a quick lift, switch over and complete the move. The dummy works by knowing the circuit and knowing the braking point. The fourth and final type of overtake we will discuss in this video is also vital in knowing where the braking point is, and that is the good old-fashioned dive bomb. Put simply, this is where you outbrake your opponent into a corner. Before undertaking this, you need to figure out how late you can brake. You can do loads of practice sessions and just go with the trial and error method, or you could simply check on Track Titan. Into turn 1 at Hungary, we can see I was braking slightly early, so with this new information, I could brake later and make a decisive pass into the corner. So as we can see, there are plenty of ways you can pass a driver ahead, and these are only a few of the many options. The more you race, the more you'll start using these subconsciously. Don't forget to sign up on TrackTide with the code OVERTAKE for 30 days of limited data insights. So that's it from us today. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you again next time.